It's a long, long road from which there is no return. And while on our way to there, why not share?
Think of the London North Western Railway mainly in terms of its West Coast mainline. It did have a major presence in South Wales, reached by virtue of running powers over the Great Western. In the yard at Abergavenny, two characteristic North Western locomotives are seen preparing for the end of an era, as the 5th of January 1958 was the closure date for the Heads of the Valleys route from Abergavenny to Merthyr. The LNWR's double-track line that had been built to take coal from South Wales to the industrial heart of England. Joining the train, we first pass through Abergavenny Brecon Road Station, the North Western's own station where its sheds were situated. The train is comprised of five LMS coaches, not a difficult task for the two engines. One of the causes of closure runs alongside as the coal tank leads the Super D round the endless succession of reverse curves, necessary to take advantage of the northern slopes of the South Wales Mountains, along which the line ran. Crowds met the train at most intermediate stations. This is Govilon, first station out from Abergavenny. Despite the speed at which we ran in, this was a stop. Wait for the restart. The two engines were rather more accustomed to freight work, both types being allocated to this very heavily graded line for use traffic for many years. This was, of course, the principal reason for its existence, passenger traffic being of a secondary nature. The coal tanks, despite their name, were used on these. Here we pass through Gilwerran Halt, the platforms of which survive today. Next are the signal box and sidings for Clydach, which are situated on the east side of a viaduct before reaching Clydach Halt, where rather fewer spectators awaited the train. These platforms also survive today. Twin tunnels avoided a diversion round the end of the mountain and through Clydach village, which is mostly situated on the northern bank of the River Clydach, whose deep valley the line had followed from Gilwerran. Here the line twisted and turned to gain height, as the valley was left near Blackrock Halt, situated at the source of the river, which fell from Mynydd or Mount Llangadog. Our next port of call is Bryn Mawr, the junction until 1954 of a line to Blaenavon, which is now reopened as a preserved line at Blaenavon as the Pontypool and Blaenavon Railway. Bryn Mawr didn't lose all its trains in 1958, as it was also the junction for a line to Nantyglo, which survived for a further 4 years. At Beaufort, the short freight branch to Ebbw Vale was taken, turning straight onto it at Ebbw Vale Junction. This LNWR branch had no connection with the Great Western lines from Newport and had lost its passenger service on the 2nd of April 1951. However, it was to last for another 21 months after the special ran, keeping the Beaufort to Nantyglo section of the Heads of the Valley line open for that period, for freight only. Nantyglo Viaduct survives today, but the rest of the trackbed from Beaufort is now a main road as far as Dowlais Top. From Nantyglo to Rumney Bridge, the Northwestern had running powers over Rumney Railway Metals, and at the latter station, the train took the Rumney Railway's main line as far as Rumney itself, forming the last train on the line to that point. This tour was organised by the Midlands area of the Stevenson Locomotive Society, the secretary of which was one W.A. Cam Camwell. So this tour was of particular interest to him. As we saw at the beginning of the first volume of this series, the SLS organised a rail tour to celebrate Cam's 80th birthday in 1986, using the selfsame coal tank used in 1958, as this was the last of the class and was subsequently preserved. We are now running into the eastern part of Merthyr at Dowlais Top. Dowlais High Street Station was on a curve as the line made its long and tortuous approach to Merthyr itself. This was the final photo stop. At Penawern Junction, a 21-chain loop joined the Brecon and Merthyr line to Dowlais Central Station. Panta's Gallag was the last purely northwestern station before the line plunged under Pant in a long tunnel to emerge at Morlaith Junction, where the Brecon and Merthyr Railway's main line joined from the north.
Fleur-de-Lis platform opened in 1926. The name could have come from a local inn. South of this halt, known locally as the Flower, the line goes under the stone arched viaduct carrying the Pontypool Road to Neath GWR line and into Mysacum. The station had two platforms and a 12-lever signal box, with goods sidings on the downside alongside Commercial Street. South of Mysacum was Barry Junction, where the Barry Railway advanced on the Rumney Valley for its coal traffic. A substantial viaduct was built over the valley in 1905, but the line went into decline and was demolished in 1937, yielding a lot of scrap steel, plus a considerable amount of hardcore. A Brecon and Merthyr somersault signal heralds our arrival at Bedwas. Next, Trithomas. The colliery can be seen in the distance. With less than 8 miles to go, Machen. This was a junction station for the Caerphilly branches, seen diverging away south. The 5 miles between Machen and Basleg allowed the crew of 4679 to put on steam, as the next two original Brecon and Merthyr stations had been closed. First is Church Road, closed in September 1957. Superb examples of the company's somersault signals, both home and distant, could be seen as we pass a northbound service. Through Derryn Station had closed earlier on the 1st of March 1954. Basleg and the end of the Brecon and Merthyr railway route, the company establishing its main running shed here. On departing south, our train passed the other Basleg station, that of the GWR route to Risker and the Western Valleys. We head down Park Mall with the Docks Line on our right towards Hillfield Tunnel and High Street Station. Here, 4679 could rest after its 47-mile journey, now at sea level and not quite as much snow.